My new build is running very well. I have the Intel 3258 overclocked at 4.5 GHz at 1.3 volts. It's running really stable, clearly not bottlenecking the HD 6670 graphics card. So one of my friends was selling a graphics card and I had the idea to upgrade that. So here is the new graphic card. It's an Asus GTX 660 Ti. It's a very good graphics card, a lot better than anything I had before. But the problem is I don't have the proper connectors on the PCU for this graphics card. And I really don't like using all kinds of adapters, because then you actually are forcing a lot more current to the original wires. So I will try to open up this PCU and connect new wires inside of it. I will have to be very careful because this is pretty dangerous. I will have to be careful for charge capacitors and stuff like that. And I will be making my new connectors from these ones, but using longer cables from this old PSU connector. And I will remove anything that is connector and it's not used in this system, because I highly doubt it that in the future I will be upgrading this system. Next step will be most likely to sell it. So anything that's not used will be removed, and I hope the PCU can power all of this, because from what I've searched online, most of the PCUs don't have much more power on the 12 volts rails. They have a lot more power on the 5 volt rails and 3.3 volt rails. So I'm using 12 volts, so two rails with 15 amps each should be more than enough, even if this PCU is rated at 350 watts maximum. It has a lot of power on the 12 volts, so I think it should be good enough for my needs. But we will see this when I finish modifying it, because I can't be sure from the beginning. Maybe what's written on here, it's not on this label, it's not completely real. And from what I know, in most cases, it's not completely real. But I hope it's close enough to the real power of the PCU. So I will start working on the new connectors and removing the old graphic card. As you can see, I've made some progress here. Removed the original black wires from the adapter and inserted the new longer ones from my old PSU. And let me try to focus a little bit closer. Okay, even closer. You can see they have these little latches on the side. So to remove them from the original connector, you have to insert to the front the screwdriver. Let me try. Okay, with my left hand, yeah, small chances. Anyway, you have to something like this on the side of it, and you come on, please focus. You actually bend these pins, the latches on the side, bend them out of the way, so you can remove the wire, and then bend them back so they clip onto place in the new connector. And also be careful, because these have these two little metal wings, I don't know how to say, and they go on channels inside the connector to stabilize this metal part. So you have to be careful to put it like this and not the other way around, because it will not go well in place and stay a little bit bent. So you should be careful at that too. First cable finished. I don't have enough yellow wires, so I'm using also red and orange for 12 volts, but that isn't a problem for me, because I know that I will be connecting this to 12 volts inside the PCU. And the other adapter, I even have to cut a part of it off, because it is an 8-pin. My wife's sneezing, sorry for that. Because it's an 8-pin adapter, and if you look at the colors of the wire, they actually suck, because they use red for ground into two places. So that is way, way worse than what I'm doing. That's another reason why I hate using adapters. So I will get working on this one. Remove, let me try and show you. You can see here, actually you can't yet. Kind of slow at focusing this camera. You can see two pins are joined together by plastic, and that's exactly the point where I have to cut off part of the adapter to transform it into a 6-pin one. So I've been doing that. Maybe even if I check on the graphics card, I will leave it an 8-pin and only cut that so it fits inside the graphics card, and the other pins I will let unused for future. Actually, why? Because I will not be upgrading this in the future, so I will not need 8-pin adapters. Yeah, I will cut it off. Okay, let's continue. In the end, I decided not to cut off the extra part of this connector, because if I use them exactly like this in the video board, it doesn't bother me at all, and I'm sure I will not be able to cut it and to look cut it with a clean cut to look good. So yeah, couldn't be bothered to cut it. We will use it like this, no problems. Quite long wires, so there will be no problem with that. I have removed the PSU from the case, and here is the fan from the PSU, PWM controlled fan. Removed from it the ID connector, because I will never use this fan without speed control, so that's no good anymore. Removed another ID connector from another Chieftec case fan, also controlled. This is the original fan from this PSU that I changed about 2 years ago, because it was getting noisy. It's a sleeve bearing type, and this one is a ball bearing type. This eventually dry out and start making noises, and I don't like to open the case and the PSU again and again to oil this up. So I've changed it with this type, and no more problems. Now I will open this PS2 even more. I hope the camera will focus so you can see. And I will attach the 12 volts wires here. I found some unused holes in the back for ground wires, but maybe I have to drill some more in this part, I will see. And I have for the CPU to add another 12 volts wire. In this rail I have 2 holes already drilled and 3, so I will use those. Now I will continue to open the PSU. I was thinking how to balance the load on both of these rails from the PSU, and then I looked on the back to see exactly where the contacts go. So this is one 12 volt rail, this is the second 12 volt rail, and they are both connected from here to here and from here to here. Let me show you what I'm talking about. You see there two wires, bare wires. Those are the connections. So two rails, no way on this PCU, it's just marketing stuff. It is a single rail, probably 30 amps. And you can see probably there is a PSU that has two rails, because here we have on the other side some unpopulated elements, connectors or holes or part of this board. So it's clearly that maybe they have one that has really two rails, but mine does not have two rails, so I couldn't care less where I connect my wires now, because everything is coming from one transformer and one single big rail. So that made it a little bit easier. I already got one 12 volts, two grounds from this that I cut out, because I will never use floppy or IDE drives. So I need just another 12 volts, and I will make one 8 pin CPU connector. I've cut a part of from the old motherboard connector. This is useless now, these parts. Throw them away. And this. Come on. Okay. This is exactly the correct shape for an 8 pin connector. Actually this in mirror on the other side, and we can see, let me try and insert it into the motherboard. Sorry, I think you can see almost anything. You can see it's even latching, although it's not centered, but it's still latching because the latch on the motherboard is longer. So it's perfect. Now I will just have to move the cables from this and add the new cables with pins from... where did I put my wires? Yeah, cannot find my wires now. Okay. Some of these probably will become donor pins. I think I just finished the hardest part of all, soldering all the wires in place. It was really hard to solder because there is a very big ground plane here and was taking all the heat away from the soldering point. So I had to use my soldering station together with my soldering iron to get enough heat to melt this, and even now it does not look very nice, but I can assure you it was perfectly melted when I worked on it. So yes, all the wires are in place now. Even the 8-pin motherboard connector that I made, these two 6-pin and 8-pin, but with only 6 wire for actually a 6-pin connector. And now I only have to add another SATA. I only have 3 SATA current ports, voltage ports. So I have to add another one without this adapter. So from the last part I took out this plastic protection and the wires are here. So I just have to cut this off and push down the wires in these sockets, if I can call them sockets. So then cut a little bit this plastic to fit correctly over that, and I have for SATA power connectors, and I hope everything will work. Of course the colors are not correct because these now have 12 volts, but I don't care because I will never use them for anything else but this build. So we continue. Well, this is where we're at now. You can see the new wires here, here, and in the back some black wires, ground wires. PCI connectors, motherboard connector, the added SATA connector, now they are 4 on the same cable, and the other motherboard, actually this is CPU. So now I will put the cover back on the power supply, put it in place and see if everything boots up normally, and then I will add the graphics card. First test was successful, everything works exactly as it did before. With the HD 6670 in place. And now I will swap the video cards and hope for the best. Everything is in place. I have to remove the original plastic bracket for the cards because it was too flimsy for this big video card. So I put two screws in there. This one I will let open because why bother, as long as I don't even have an IO shield on this motherboard. Not important in this case. So here are the wires that I made, staying very well in the graphics card. Now it's just a matter of powering it up and seeing how it all performs. In case anybody was wondering, this is just silicone rubber or something, auto adhesive, put on the hard drive because the hard drive was making the case vibrate and make a lot of noise when working. So this is taking away all the vibrations. Now let's power it up. As you can see, everything is running perfectly now. CPU at 4.5 GHz overclock. Graphics card I did not yet overclock, it's at standard frequency, boost working. 12 volts rail, is at 12.2 volts. No problems there. It never went below this, so below 12 volts, maybe below a little bit. From time to time it's dipping even at idle, but even in full load it never went below 12 volts, so no problems. Nothing is overheating, the PSU is not heating up at all. This is the PSU fan at 1330 for the moment RPM. When the CPU is under load, it gets about 1500 RPMs. CPU fan and the first auxiliary fan work together. So when the CPU fan is throttling up, this one is also throttling up to about 2500 RPM. That's a little bit much and they make a lot of noise, but with the cooler that I have now on the CPU, Zalman CNP-SX5 Performa, something like that. I can't do anything about it. If I lower the RPM, the CPU is going to overheat, so I will leave it like this until I get a better cooler, but I don't know if it's worth it, because only in very high loads the noise is extremely annoying. And the last fan is the front fan from the case. It stays at this RPM almost all the time, throttles up only about 100 RPM when the CPU is under very high load. So it's pretty good. The GPU has plenty of power, no problems. It has two green LEDs where the 6-pin connectors fit in, and both of those LEDs light up, so it's clearly getting its power. I've also used MSI afterburner and no problems with the power, so it's clearly all okay. So it seems that in my case at least, a 350 watts PSU can be modified to accommodate this Pentium CPU and a GTX 660 Ti with no problems. Under heavy load on both CPU and GPU, I got a power consumption of about 250, maybe 260 maximum watts. And before changing the graphics card, I was getting about 160 watts. So yes, my previous graphics card was using maximum 50 watts, and this one is using maximum 150 watts. And yeah, exactly what I expected. And this is way below the maximum 350 watts from my PSU. And it really seems that my PSU can output that much without having any difficulties heating up or anything. No, absolutely no problem. Everything is running perfectly. I hope this video was useful to some of you. And I will put in the links in the description, I will put a link to a great article that I used when I made this modification to the PSU. That article made me understand a lot of things about the power requirements of the graphic cards and CPUs in general, and how much actually you need for them. So thank you very much for watching, and see you again next time.